The 2019 Women's World Cup kicks off in Paris on Friday. Let the Mondlane celebration begin. More Women's World Cup news. Host Nation France are the joint favorites to win the World Cup alongside the reigning champs the US. National team, and they host South Korea at the Parc des Princes in what will be a huge party atmosphere in the French capital. Eugénie Lesommes, Amandine Henry and Wendy Renard will lead France charge this summer, with the tournament about to kick off. You can watch every single game live online in Spanish via Telemundo Deportes. All you have to do is click on the link below. Live watch every single 2019 Women's World Cup game from June 7 to July 7. Here we go. Follow at jpw_nbigsports. Lionel Messi and Luis Suarez are both in typical goal-scoring form as their international sides ramp up for the imminent 2019 Copa America. Messi bucked a quick-fire brace in the first half of Argentina's 5-1 beatdown of Nicaragua, scoring in the 37th minutes to key the win. The first was a classic Messi stunner where he dribbled past nearly the entire Nicaragua defense, skipping by no less than 4 defenders before depositing the ball in the back of the net with ease. Goal for Argentina. In who else? It's Lionel Messi, in typical magisterial form, skips past the Nicaraguan players and opens the scoreline for the hosts with a simple finish. Pick.twitter.com/invest4v8v in Sports USA at Bein Sports USA, June 8, 2019 his second cameo as Argentina went right back on the attack with Sergio Aguero rifling a shot on net that was saved by Nicaragua goalkeeper Justo Llorente only for it to fall right at the feet of Messi who completed a sliding finish under pressure. The Barcelona superstar was withdrawn at halftime for Juventus attacker Paulo Dybala. Overall, it was a dominating performance from Argentina, holding 67% possession and putting 8 of their 19 shots on target. Electric 21-year-old Inter-Striker Lautaro Martinez scored a second half brace to double Argentina's lead, a positive sign for the country that has searched far and wide for someone to share the goal-scoring load with Messi. Roberto Pereira completed the scoreline with a late tap-in, while the backline that consisted at times of Nicolas Otamendi, Juan Foyth, and Ramiro Funes Mori held Nicaragua to a measly 2 total shots with 0 on target until stoppage time when Juan Barrera put Nicaragua on the board from the penalty spot. While Messi was clowning the Nicaragua backline, his Barcelona teammate Luis Suarez was on target as Uruguay had no trouble dispatching Panama 3-0. The 32-year-old came off the bench alongside Edinson Cavani in the 63rd minute and 6 minutes later, he dispatched a Messi-like free kick that found the top left corner and left Panamanian goalkeeper Luis Mejía no chance, making the game 2-0 at the time. The Uruguay defense looked tournament ready as well, holding Panama to just one shot on target in 5 overall efforts on net. The game was a foul fest, with the sides combining to produce 43 whistles, although only one yellow card was issued. Uruguay dominated the attacking play, holding 64% of possession in inning 10 corners while Panama did not take a single one. Argentina will begin Copa America play next Saturday as it takes on Colombia in group stage play. Uruguay, meanwhile, gets underway a day later, set to face Ecuador before a meeting with AFC guest Japan. Follow at the_bonfire according to Italian tabloid Corriere dello Sport as reported by Football Italia, Manchester United has submitted a bid for Napoli defender Kalidou Koulibaly upwards of $107.70 million. The report states that since the Red Devils are anticipating a swinging miss on Matisse Delict, they have now set their sights on the 27-year-old Senegal international who has been an absolute workhorse for the Serie A side since joining in 2014. Koulibaly has made at least 27 Serie A appearances in each of his 5 seasons at Napoli, topping the 30-game mark in 3 of the last 4 seasons, including 35 games played in each of the last 2 campaigns. Koulibaly reportedly has a $170 million release clause that becomes active next summer, with his contract not set to expire until the summer of 2023, having signed an extension just last year. Still, Koulibaly has been a wanted man over the past few years, with Napoli fending off rumors constantly. Napoli President Aurelio De Laurentiis has been firm in his valuation of $113 million for Koulibaly even as far back as last November when reports came out of a bid from Manchester United. Corriere dello Sport themselves reported that Napoli rejected a bid $102 million from Real Madrid for Koulibaly back in late May, proving De Laurentiis a tough nut to crack. However, if the latest bid is indeed a reality, it could test the executive's resolve with the submission coming so close to his valuation and providing the club with a massive financial influx. Koulibaly is currently on international duty with Senegal in the African Cup of Nations, set to begin play in the tournament on June 23 when they take on Tanzania in the first game of group stage play. They have a friendly against Nigeria to navigate first, scheduled for June 16. Koulibaly's last 2 starts for Senegal both ended in clean sheets, with wins over Equatorial Guinea and Madagascar completing the AFCON qualification cycle. Follow at the _ bonfire with Neymar confirmed injured for the duration of the upcoming Copa America. His club team is concerned about how his ankle problem could affect the start of next season. Paris Saint-Germain confirmed on Friday that they have sent a pair of doctors to Brazil to assess Neymar, who was injured in the 2-0 friendly win over Qatar on Wednesday. The Brazilian superstar could be seen in tears on the sidelines after being withdrawn in the 21. Minute, requiring help from 2 trainers to eventually make his way into the locker room. On Friday, 7 June, Paris Saint-Germain's first team doctor, Dr. Laurent Aumont, and the club's medical board member and leading figure in sportmedicine, Professor Gérard Saliant, traveled to Brazil. Paris Saint-Germain said in a statement released on Friday. The 2 doctors will define the player's rehabilitation process and recovery time as per the medical protocol, 72 hours after Neymar's injury. The Brazilian Federation announced following the Qatar game that Neymar suffered a sprain that involves a ligament rupture, confirming that he will miss the entire Copa America. The oddest part of the entire situation is Neymar's Twitter post on Friday morning saying that he was making his way to France for the opening match of the Women's World Cup, which is away France top South Korea 4-0. Yet Neymar is supposedly in Paris for the opening match of the Women's World Cup. Nachdenkendes Gesicht https://t.co/nxmayi, Jonathan Johnson at John. Legosip, June 7, 2019. Given that his recent injury would likely lead to an aversion of air travel, it's possible that Neymar's post was nothing more than a Qatar Airways sponsored tweet with broken English leading to a misunderstanding, but still it's odd that Neymar would post about him traveling to somewhere he's not actually going to. It's also possible that the tweet was a scheduled post that was never removed despite plans changing after the injury. Still, the dichotomy between Neymar's announced travel plans and those of his club is questionable. We knew Neymar was in Brazil as recently as late Thursday or early Friday, as he was brought in for questioning by Brazilian police with regards to the investigation of the rape allegations brought against him. Neymar's social media posts have been problematic of late. His Instagram rant about Champions League refereeing earlier this year saw him suspended for 3 continental games while a post in response to rape allegations could have him in potential legal trouble in Brazil. Follow at the _ bonfire with Eden Hazard's transfer to Real Madrid complete announced Friday by both clubs in a deal that could reach as high as $195 million. It was time for the 28-year-old to say goodbye to the Blues after 7 years with the club. Hazard joined Chelsea back in 2012 from French side Lille in a $39 million deal as a 21-year-old. He became a fixture at the club, making 352 appearances across all competitions and scoring 110 goals plus another 92 assists. Hazard was known at Chelsea for his silky on-ball skills and his ability to cut in front wide areas, a vicious creative force that terrorized the Premier League with his magical moves. When departing the Premier League club for his dream side Real Madrid, Hazard penned a lengthy and heartfelt goodbye to the club that helped him become the best in the world, posting the full statement on his personal Facebook page. Hazard referred to the London club as special multiple times and noted how the fans helped him grow from a young player arriving from France into the world-class attacker he is today. "I was only 21 when I joined," Hazard wrote, "so I have grown up as a man and a player with all of you. You have helped me become captain of the Belgium national team after all. There have of course been tough times for the team as a whole and for me personally. This is professional football. However, football to me is about having a ball at my feet, playing games and enjoying every moment. We are lucky to play the beautiful game and this is always my advice to those who ask for a coaching tip. Play football and have fun. Even when we were not playing well, I tried to do my best and this has been thanks to your amazing support. That fighting spirit, desire and the refusal to ever give up is part of the culture here at Chelsea and it comes directly from you. Some players hope never to play against their long-time former clubs out of a love for the team, but Hazard took a different approach. He knows he'll miss playing in London, and therefore wants to play against Chelsea as many times as possible in the future, not hoping to beat them over and over, but instead born out of a sheer desire to be in front of the Chelsea fans again. Chelsea fans will always be special to me next season. I will look for your results first. Hazard said. I hope that we are drawn against each other in the Champions League next season and every season so we can meet again, no matter what happens the rest of his career. Eden Hazard will be known as a special Chelsea player who made countless memories for Blues supporters on and off the pitch. Follow at the _ bonfire let's block @. Why?